people. Be in God's activator.
Yes, God. Yes, he was.
When Moses go to my God Almighty Pharaoh, what God did? God, can everybody say God is something else?
Yes.
He is my something else. Look what God did. Can you imagine? People would say, oh, God is wicked. He wasn't wicked.
No.
Oh, a little frail mind that don't understand and can go way above and beyond. To tap in. To tap in. Not just to imagine. Not just to imagine it.
No.
Not just to imagine, but to tap in. Come on, people.
Yes.
To tap into God. To understand, my God Almighty, what God is about. Because God tell Moses, my God Almighty, what God said. Tell Moses, go and tell Pharaoh to let my people go.
Lord.
You see, you have to get to a place. What if, my God Almighty, you are God's activator? And in the midst, my God Almighty, God gives you a message to go and give to Donald Trump.
Yes.
Some of you are going to be surprised at that. Oh, Lord Jesus, help me, Lord. Help me, Jesus. God give you a message to go and give to Donald Trump. And you know for sure that God give you that message to give him. And you know, my God Almighty, the way he behaves, you know his ways, you know everything. You're going to say, oh, God, no, God, not me, not me, God, not me, not me. Right, dear, you need to understand, if you are God's activator, you cannot have fear. You have to bold. Be bold. Come on, people. Come on, people. Come on, people. Because you need to understand, in the midst of you going to give that message to Donald Trump, let me tell you what God will do as an activator for him. When you go, my God Almighty, and you see whoever is at the gate, my God Almighty God, and you said, I have a message from God for Donald Trump.
Yeah.
I said, ma'am, if you know what is best, leave. I said, in the name of Jesus Christ, go and deliver that message to him. Right, dear, the power of God must be so strong to push that servant to him.
Yes.
Come on, people.
Yes.
Whenever my God, and as soon as that person go to him, come on, people. As soon as he hear it, he must able to give in to it. Because what happened? Right, dear people of God, God is on your side. He send you. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
Come on, people.
Amen.
You know, in life, you have some people that God started out having them as his activator, and guess what? They lose it. Come on, people, they lost it. Come on, talk to me. They lost it. Because the things of the world have them to get what? Carried away. Come on, people. I said they get carried away by other things. Just like Peter, that was carried away by the wind. Come on, people. He looked at the wind and he saw it and he started to sink. Many people have been carried away by the things of the wind. Come on, people. You see, people of God, when you become an activator for God, look, now, what you all need to understand, a man like Pharaoh, You don't, you all don't even get and understand the wickedness of Pharaoh. Pharaoh was a wicked man. He would kill you right before everybody and just have his people to pull you and draw you away. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
I'm not talking about no movie now.
No.
That man was raging with my God Almighty. It's about me, myself, and I, because he called himself a God. Come on, people.
Yes.
Pharaoh called himself a God. And because he called himself a God, you find right there, my God Almighty, he did not have no fear for nobody. Not even the God of Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac, he did not fear. Come on, talk to me. But when God sent Moses into him, what happened? Moses was what? Very obedient. You have to be obedient for God. Come on, people. You have to be, let me talk to myself. You have to be obedient for God. You can't be, my God Almighty, a person that when God is sending you somewhere, you're telling God, God, I don't think we should go. Look at this. When Jesus hear about Lazarus, and Jesus decide to go back, my God Almighty, where Lazarus was, the disciples them start to question him. Master, do you think you should go? I don't think you should go. You know, Pastor, those people, they will want to kill you. They will want to this. They will want to that. And Jesus have to be bold. Come on, people. They look at my God Almighty, Jesus, and they said, Jesus said, Lazarus died. He said, yes, I know he died. I know Lazarus dead. I said, but Master, if he dead, why should you go there? He said, he's sleeping. Then he have to tell them, my God Almighty, yes, he died, but I have to go for the glory of my Father. You have to get to that place, my God Almighty. I guess everybody is sleeping, busy, can't able to be in agreement. So let me just talk it. Holy Spirit of God, the angel of the living God, be in the midst, God, be in the midst. You see, my God Almighty, it happened that Moses, God was to be obedient to the Spirit of God when God tell him to go, even though Pharaoh decided not to do it. He did not have any fear. He was very bold. He was very bold to go in. My God Almighty. He was very bold to go in and to my God Almighty deliver the word to my God Almighty Pharaoh. And what happened in the midst? Pharaoh, my God Almighty, want to understand which God is this sending you to me. So right there, that is all he had, was to show him God's power through the rod that was given to him to trample over scorpion and serpent. And right there, my God Almighty, Jesus Christ, have mercy, help me, Lord. He go in, and the power of God was known to men. All these, my God Almighty, things happen in the midst, because right there, God have him to go to and fro, going from the temple of Pharaoh, and to go, my God Almighty, to sit in the presence of him, to talk to him, to talk to God. God, I went to him and he did not answer. Go back and tell him I said to let my people go. Moses was very, my God Almighty, bold to go, my God Almighty, before Pharaoh. Pharaoh could have, my God Almighty, tried to kill him. The Bible, the movie did not show it. The Bible did not say it. But people of God, what you all need to understand, Pharaoh was raging with anger because he have unforgiveness in his heart against Moses for killing one of the servants. Still yet, he's the one God used to send here. He went, and God Almighty have accomplished great work through him in the midst of the wilderness. When he, my God Almighty, get my God Almighty down to everything by doing all what God said, and Pharaoh had was to surrender. What happened right there? He was at the seaside. They were coming. He causes, my God Almighty, hallelujah, the fire of God Almighty stand in the way to block them. What happened right there? Moses was able to hold the rod up and to send forth, my Raboshatayamakunde, my God Almighty, was able to send forth the people through the land, through the Red Sea, where the power of God, hallelujah, the same, my God Almighty, power that God Almighty has used Moses to do in the midst of being an activator for God, God can do it as well. There is nothing that is too hard for God to do. He's the same God yesterday, today, and forever, my God Almighty. He's the same God. There is nothing that is too hard for God to do, to use somebody to do, to bring glory to his name. He has used, my God Almighty, my God Almighty, Moses in the midst of the wilderness. Many miracles, my God Almighty, many signs and wonder has come forth. The water, my God Almighty, was able to rush out of the gas, out of the rock. The water that was, my God Almighty, dirty and wasn't good to drink, he, my God Almighty, Moses, was able, my God Almighty, to touch that water, my God Almighty, with the rod, and cause his, my God Almighty, the water to come clean. Come on, people of God. My God Almighty, he was able to do it. It happened, my God Almighty. Because what? Being an activator for God, as long as you make yourself available, God can use you. There is nothing that happened way back, my God Almighty, back then, that God cannot do it now. He can do it. Read in the Bible. That is the reason why he gave us, my God Almighty, the Bible to read, and for us to read the Bible. And by reading the Bible, we can able, my God Almighty, to desire great things of God. But right there, we all have to understand, desiring great things of God, there have to be a process. My God Almighty, it's not just, my God Almighty, hallelujah, doing it, my God Almighty, tell God you want to do it and it happen right away. No, don't happen like that. You desire gift of God, but to be an activator for God and know that you are called, my God Almighty, to do it, and know the things that God speak in your spirit, you can, my God Almighty, get to that place for God to use you. As I said before, my God Almighty, it's not about, my God Almighty, you to be seen or to be heard. It's not about, my God Almighty, flesh to be in the midst to operate while God is doing it. It's all about, my God Almighty, it's all about the Spirit of God in operation through your life. My God Almighty, great and mighty things, my God Almighty, can happen in your life as well. The same way, my God Almighty, Moses, my God Almighty, you can be in a wilderness by yourself and needed, my God Almighty, water and don't have water. And God can, my God Almighty, cause his water to, my God Almighty, flow from the ground. Or, my God Almighty, come through a tree. There is nothing that is impossible for God to do. When you make yourself available to be used by God, my God Almighty, the few people that are online. Oh, Jesus, have mercy, God, have mercy. Those that, my God, be in agreement after, my God, leave. And I know one or two of you, my God, is at your work and doing whatever. So that's all right. You see, my God Almighty, people of God, you have to, my God Almighty, get to a place in your life where, my God Almighty, if you know you made mistake, you can, my God Almighty, stand to correction. You have to. Many people, my God, you cannot correct them. I am willing for correction. If I do something, I am willing to, my God Almighty, to be corrected and stand to it. But if I don't do it, I won't argue it. I'll just say, let me put it in the hands of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because it is very, my God Almighty, hallelujah, very impossible for you to know that you don't do something and take the blame for it. It is impossible. It's not supposed to happen. But you have to get to that place where you can, my God Almighty, hallelujah, take correction. You can't be self-righteous, my God Almighty. You cannot be self-righteous, because if you are self-righteous, God can't able to use you. My God Almighty. There is nothing that is too hard for God to do, I said, people of God. There is nothing too hard. What happened, my God? You see, the thing about it is that many people, they limit God, and that's where the problem is. A lot of us want to limit God. And if we, my God Almighty, wasn't the type of people to limit God, I rise up to tell you, my God Almighty, God would able to do great and mighty things in a lot of us lives. But we want to limit God too much. We want to limit God too much. And because, my God Almighty, we get to that place where we want to limit God, God can't able to use those that He, my God Almighty, has chosen and has called to be His activator, to, my God Almighty, have us to be active for Him. Whatever He tell us to, Rabo Shataya Makunde, whatever He tell us to do, we can do it. My God Almighty. Many people said they give themselves away for God to use them. But that's a lie from the pit of hell. It's not everybody do it. My God Almighty. Some people, my God Almighty, are willing to be used by God. And my God Almighty are called to be His activator. But they are stronghold in the midst of them. Pray, my God Almighty. If they are willing, my God Almighty, hallelujah, to get help, they can get help. Because there are some that are fighting whatever is going on with themselves. And they cannot, my God Almighty, hallelujah, do it all by themselves. They need somebody that is more, my God Almighty, in God, that can help to pull that, my God Almighty, stronghold out of their life. It can happen. I said it can happen. It can happen, because the God of Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac, there is nothing that is too hard for God to do. It's not hard. God is able to see us through. He is God. He is Lord. He is King. He is the Savior. He is the Redeemer. He is the Holy One of Israel that can do great and mighty things. My God Almighty. We only have to get to that place, my God Almighty, to know that He is God, and all the glory and all the honor belongeth unto Him. And when we, my God Almighty, can see ourselves in that place, then, my God Almighty, the glory of God will able to move. The glory of God will able to take over. The glory of God will able, my God Almighty, to ride over our life, and where we can, my God Almighty, give God all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor. Glory be to God, hallelujah. There are so much, my God Almighty, ways that God can use us. He have done it, my God Almighty, even in the midst. Elijah and Elisha, they were, my God Almighty, all these servants of God, my God Almighty, was, my God Almighty, God's activator. We go through, my God Almighty, hallelujah, in the Bible, my God Almighty, You go in there, my God Almighty, from Genesis all the way down Deuteronomy. You know, Joshua was one, my God Almighty. In the book of Judges, my God Almighty, you find, my God Almighty, hallelujah, servant. That was God's activator. You find, my God Almighty, in Ruth, my God Almighty, where she was God's activator. In the book of 1 and 2 Samuel, my God Almighty, you know, my God Almighty, dear, with Samuel, with my God Almighty, name it. My God Almighty, more than one, my God Almighty, servant of the Most High God. Solomon, my God Almighty, was one of God's activator, where God Almighty was using him in a different way. My God Almighty, you find people of God, my God Almighty, in the book of Kings, my God Almighty, as I said, people of God, with Elijah and Elisha. You find, my God Almighty, in the book of Chronicles, all the way, my God Almighty, right through the book, in, my God Almighty, hallelujah, Ezra, Nehemiah was, my God Almighty, one of God's activator, where he was busy, my God Almighty, doing things that God Almighty commanded him to do. People of God, Esther get to a place where she, my God Almighty, because there are different levels, but my God Almighty, to get to that higher heights and deeper depths in God, to really and truly, my God Almighty, hallelujah, get to that place where you become, my God Almighty, holy and solely unto God, where there is nothing else, my God Almighty, but the Spirit of God taking over your life. You have the fear of God, you're living for Him, doing great and mighty things. You need to understand, people of God, all the way, my God Almighty, from Genesis to, my God Almighty, Revelation, you will, my God Almighty, see where there were servants, my God Almighty, of God, doing, my God Almighty, great and mighty work for Him, being His activator, my God Almighty.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Thank you for coming in the midst to help lift up the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Being the activator for God is to bring glory unto His name, where God can use you to do more than you can ever imagine or think.
Yes, God. Thank you, Lord.
There is nothing that is too hard. There is nothing that happened back then that God can't use somebody to do now. Nothing.
Amen.
There is nothing. Whatever miracle happened back then can happen now.
Thank you, Jesus.
The same way, my God Almighty, Elijah, when he died, my God Almighty, the word of God said, Elijah, my God Almighty, very bone, was able, my God Almighty, to be used, my God Almighty, to bring back a dead man. God can do it.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Elisha, my God Almighty, Elisha was God's activator. I believe, my God Almighty, right through, my God Almighty, his days of living for God and doing for God. People of God, if you should read, my God Almighty, the Bible, go right through. I believe it's about 36 miracles that Elijah have done, my God. God has used Elijah to do. 36 miracles, different miracles. 36 different type of miracles. There is nothing that is too hard for God to do. Nothing.
Glory be to God.
He is God. He can do any. Let me say this. God can do anything, but He don't have to do everything.
Yes, yes.
And that's where I always catch myself with Him. Because that's what He tell me. He said, I am the God, I can do everything, but I will not allow any and anyone to do everything.
Hallelujah.
And even Him Himself, He will not do everything. We're us as human beings are concerned. Because if you notice, sometimes some people would want to use the power of God to do some things that God will not allow to happen. Come on, talk to me.
Yes.
He will not allow it to happen. Because some of us, sometimes we pray amiss. Sometimes we pray amiss. And that's the other thing about it, my God Almighty, being the activator of God, you have to have a prayer life.
Yes.
You have to have a prayer life to the max. A prayer life to the max. A prayer life to the max. Whenever God said pray, you pray. You must always have the urge to pray.
Amen.
is. You see, people can have the urge to eat, to drink, to do this, to do that. But sometimes when it comes on to prayer, it's one of the hardest things. And that is something that you have to have a prayer life and have to be in the Word of God daily. 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 That is the reason why I speak it the other day, my God Almighty, where I said, people of God, I was off track with God. I'm not afraid to say it. It's already out there. No, it's not out there. It's not out there. I don't get to put it on yet. Because the movie maker is acting up, so I have to get somebody to help me fix it. Right there, my God Almighty. People of God, you have to understand. To be the activator of God is not something, my God Almighty, to take lightly. You cannot take it lightly.
No.
You cannot take it lightly. That is the reason why the Lord God Almighty tell us, my God Almighty, in His Word, people of God, in Matthew 6:33 said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all His righteousness, then all other things shall be added. You can't be a person that want to be, my God Almighty, materialistic.
Right. Amen.
To be an activator for God, can't be materialistic. Cannot. Cannot.
No.
Cannot. You have to get to a place, my God Almighty, where you have to find yourself more in the spirit than in the flesh. Wonder if you all get what I'm saying.
Yes.
You have to be more in the spirit than in the flesh. And that is what many people don't get and understand. Many people don't get and understand that. God of Jeremiah, my God Almighty, to be His activator. Where He look at him, my God, from a small as He call his forth, call him forth, and He tell him, see in the 10th verse of Jeremiah 1, He said, see, I have set thee this day over the nation and over the kingdom to root out, to pull down, to destroy, to throw down, to build and to plant. If you, my God Almighty, get to a place in God where you have to do these things, how can you, my God Almighty, just lay back to be that person? Right there, Jeremiah was an activator for God. Come on, people. As a prophet.
Amen. Yes.
As a prophet. He get to a place, my God Almighty, where he could not even, my God Almighty, married. Come on, people.
Amen.
He didn't have wives. He have to give himself away completely to God for God to use him. For God to use him, people. Jesus Christ, have mercy, God Almighty. Many people don't seem to get and understand that, my God Almighty, right there, we in the midst of doing it, you know that you will have the protection of God upon your life. Being an activator for God, you will able to even be in the midst of a situation where you go, my God Almighty, and what happened right there, the very, my God Almighty, gunman will want to come, people of God, in the midst and want to stick you up and cannot do it. Come on, talk to me. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Can't even, my God Almighty, put that gun on you to shoot you. They will draw the trigger and it will not go off. Why? Because when you are God's activator, God is inside out all over you.
Hallelujah.
He's inside out, all over you. So right there, my God Almighty, whoever, my God Almighty, is even planning to kill you, cannot touch you. Because what God said, you can't touch my anointed, come on. Or you can't do my prophet no harm. Because being his activator, my God Almighty, you are well covered with the power of God, my God Almighty. Well covered with the power of God. The gates of hell will not able to prevail over your life, just like how God tell it to Peter. It will not. In the midst, my God Almighty, with the disciples, with Jesus, my God Almighty, when Peter was there, when you get down into Acts 2, you see, my God Almighty, where Peter becomes the activator for God. Come on, people. In the midst of Acts, when Peter started, my God Almighty, the word of God said, there were, my God Almighty, so much people were added to the, my God Almighty, the kingdom of God. Because what? Peter decided to become the activator for God. Even in the midst of him going into the jail house, my God Almighty, the angel of God visiting there and burst the jail house open to bring him out. Because what? He is the activator for God. As a, my God Almighty, as a servant of the Most High God, an apostle. Come on, people. It could not, my God Almighty. The jailhouse could not hold him down. Because right there, my God Almighty, he was very active for God, activator. Many people are not active for God. You have some people, they limit God. They limit God Almighty and whatever they are to do. My God Almighty, they come with their program, and they're telling what they're going to do. And they have limited time for this. This person must pray for 5 minutes. This person must do this for 2 minutes. The only thing I see many don't have limited time on is the offering. Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy. They don't have limited time on the offering. The offering can take as much as ever. Right through the service, the offering can keep flowing. But when it comes on to prayer, if the Spirit of God said pray, no, they want to preach. If the Spirit of God said preach, no, they want to do this. If the Spirit of God said sing songs of Zion, no, they want to do that. There are many that are not being led by the Spirit of God. And still, my God Almighty, they are there in the midst doing, my God Almighty. But to be an activator for God, you have to be under his subjection, where whatever he say, that's what lie. Nothing else matter, nothing else lie. You can't do anything but what God said. When he tell us, my God Almighty, to seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, then all other things shall be added unto you. You all need to get and understand. See, being an activator for God, you have to seek God as often as you can, so that he can able, my God Almighty, to have you, my God Almighty, on the right track where he want to have you, so that the enemy will not overpower you. Because you need to understand, Satan, my God Almighty, always coming at people, my God Almighty, those that, my God, want to stand in right standing with God, to be his activator, to bring glory and honor to his name. Because you need to understand, there are many out there, my God Almighty, that is waiting and calling out for God to have someone to come in the midst to help them. My God Almighty, hallelujah. So right there, my God Almighty, being the activator for God, it's not easy. It's not something, my God Almighty, for you to do, to be seen and to be heard. It's not about how much you can pray, how much you can this, how much you can that. It's about him using you and glory coming to his name in whatever you are doing. Because right there, my God Almighty, you make sure that you don't, my God Almighty, take the glory of God. That's very dangerous right there. Very, very dangerous. My God Almighty. See what happened? There was a servant, my God Almighty, Ananias. He was, my God Almighty, he's an example of being the activator for God, being one of God's activators. When God Almighty, hallelujah, when God had was to knock down Saul on the road of Damascus. And when my God Almighty Saul, my God Almighty, got up, he realized that he was blind. He could not open his eyes. He realized that he was blind. So they had was to take him by his hands and take him into Damascus. And for 3 days he was there without sight, my God Almighty. And while he was there 3 days without sight, my God, he did not drink or eat. The word of God said that Saul, before Paul, before he becomes Paul, he could not eat, he did not eat or drink, because the Spirit of God have him under restriction. Come on, people. The Spirit of God have him under restriction right there. And in the midst, my God Almighty, of him right there, there was a certain man, my God Almighty, that lived, my God Almighty, in Damascus. He was a disciple of God. And his name was Ananias. While he was there, my God Almighty, he felt into a vision. And in the midst of him being in the vision, my God Almighty, the Lord God Almighty said, behold. And he hear what God said, and God said, I am sending you, arise and go into the street which is called Straight. There was a street that is called Straight. And he said, inquire in the houses of Judah, for dear, my God Almighty, there is one that is called Saul. And right there, my God Almighty, he went in. Saul of Tarsus. Saul was of Tarsus. That's where he's from. And right there, my God Almighty, and my God, the Lord God Almighty said, because he prayed, he is talking to God. Saul, pray. You see what happened? Before he becomes, my God Almighty, Paul, he was able to pray. So that right there, he was, my God Almighty, crying out to God to hear and answer his cry. And I, Ananias, my God Almighty, went in and he prayed. And God heard the prayer of Saul, and God sent Ananias. And he, my God Almighty, went in, my God Almighty. He said he had seen a vision. And Ananias, my God Almighty, come and put his hands upon him and tell him to receive his sight. So right there, even in the midst, I'm telling you, when you becomes God activator to the, my God Almighty, to a place where God can use you wholly and solely, you need to understand, people of God, even in vision, God will use you. He will use you in vision. Somebody will be sleeping and be somewhere, my God Almighty, and they will be praying to God. They will pray to God and name it and one of you. And God can send you as, my God, his activator in the midst of that vision to, my God, touch that person and to heal them. Come on, people. God can do it. It's not, there's nothing that is too hard for God to do. He can do it in the midst of the vision. And he can also have it done, my God Almighty, openly, in the midst where you can see the person come and do it. Because right there, my God Almighty, in the midst of, my God Almighty, Saul, before he becomes Paul, the Lord God Almighty sent in Ananias, and he was able to see. Right there, he was able to see again. And what kind of see was able to see? The look that he used to look, he don't look anymore. He start to see in the spiritual. Come on, people. God has to blind him from this wickedness and cause him to start to see the things of God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So right there, my God Almighty, God has used, my God Almighty, his disciples, them to do so much thing. He in the midst of Stephen being God's activator. Stephen was stoned, people of God. And my God, and might even in death, my God, when Stephen was dying, he cried out to God and said, lay these things not to their charge. And he go forth, my God Almighty, and go down. He was, my God Almighty, a part of God's activator right there. Barnabas. Barnabas and my God Almighty, Peter, all of them, my God Almighty, as an apostle, they declare, my God Almighty, the things, my God Almighty, that they have seen where Jesus Christ has done in the midst of them. They have spoken it, they have preached it, they have done great things in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Be in an active, be in an activator for God. God was able to use them, my God Almighty. They heal the sick. Come on, people. They was able to heal the sick. They caused, my God Almighty, blind eyes to open. The lame walk. The lame walk. The dumb speak. The leopard were dried up. The cripple, my God Almighty, becomes, my God Almighty, whole again and not cripple anymore. Great and mighty things God has wrought, my God Almighty, through their life, because they were God's activator. And that's the same thing God, my God Almighty, is using, my God Almighty, a few people today to be his activator. Come on, people. His activator right there. My God Almighty. He's using, my God Almighty, people to, my God Almighty, to God use people to do the interpretation of dreams, vision, name it, people of God. So many things, my God Almighty. Be in God's activator. He, God Almighty, has done it. He get to a place where he have Paul, my God Almighty, after taking away his sight and have him to see again, he becomes Paul, my God Almighty. And right there, he becomes the activator for God, where he have been through so much, my God, even, my God Almighty, get to a place where they want to kill him. Come on, people. Get to a place where they even want to kill him. He was God's activator. Many miracles, many signs, many wonders, many things that has wrought through the life of Paul. He causes many today, my God Almighty, to be living upright. In the book, my God Almighty, from people of God, hallelujah. From the book of Acts, come all the way around, my God Almighty. We read it, we see, my God Almighty, the great and mighty things that Paul has done for God. All the disciples there, my God, was doing great work for him. Peter, Paul, Luke, name it, people of God. Come all the way around, my God Almighty. Where John, my God Almighty, was there as one. Doing great and mighty things for the Lord Jesus Christ. There is nothing too hard if we follow the above of everything that the Holy Spirit has spoken, and many more things that can even add to it. We will see, people of God, a clean hands and a pure in heart shall see God. Being an activator for God, you have to have a clean hands and a pure in heart. You will see God in everything that you do. Fire, my God Almighty, will fall from you. People of God Almighty, great things will happen. People will touch you, my God Almighty, and they will feel Robo Shataya Makunde, the fire of God flowing through your life. Come on, people. Be an activator for God. When you give yourself away completely, that's how you will able to be it. Not to, my God Almighty, just to sing it. Not to, my God Almighty, just to, my God, perform for God today. And then tomorrow, my God Almighty, you're not in the mood to do it. But to constantly doing for God. to bring glory to him. To know that you're not running by Berwick battery. You're not running by electric. You're running by the Holy Spirit of God. You will able to be, my God Almighty, that activator for God. Where your body, my God Almighty, can get enough rest in the midst. Where you're not overworked by the natural, but you can able to do for God in the spiritual. Because your strength is not yours. Wherever you are weak, God is strong. He will be able to do it. Whenever you're doing whatever you're doing, you don't do it because of the flesh. You do it with the Spirit of God in the midst. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Where the glory of God can be known. There is nothing too hard for God to do. When we, my God Almighty, really get to that place, my God Almighty, to live a life, my God Almighty, you might not, my God Almighty, able to fast every day, but to live a life of fasting and prayer. I know that, my God Almighty, you're under the subjection of God doing it. Not to follow. Not to see somebody do it. And not to want to do it because you want to lose weight. Right there, sickness will override you. Not to do it because you want to lose weight. Oh, I like the way, my God Almighty, God is using Apostle Sharon. Because she fasts and she pray. Oh, she's slim and she's so slim and trim. I have to do it too. No, that is not of God. Did God tell you to do it? Did God call you to do it? Only when God is in it, you can do it and accomplish from it. Glory be to God. I wonder if you all hear what I'm saying. Only when God is in it, you can do it and accomplish from it. For his name to be glorified. Not for flesh to be satisfied, but for his name to be glorified. Because whatever you're doing, you must do it unto the glory of God. For the name of the Lord Jesus Christ to be glorified, I am lifted up. For he is Lord, he is God. He is able, my God Almighty, to see each and everyone through. It must be all about him, none of you, and all about God. It must not be about, my God Almighty, you. Where you want to, my God Almighty, hallelujah, to be seen and to be heard by others. It's not about that. The glory of God must be in the midst to do great and mighty things, my God Almighty. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. We bless you. God, I praise and glorify you. I honor you, Lord Jesus Christ, for your goodness and your mercy. For your loving kindness towards us, oh God Almighty. I ask you, Lord God Almighty, to be glorified. I am lifted up. For you, O God Almighty, is the Lord Jesus Christ. There is no God like you. You are the only true and living God. Hallelujah. You are the great High Priest. You are the great I Am. The King of all kings and the Lord of all lords. Conquering Lion of Zion. Father God, I thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for coming in the midst, Lord God Almighty, to do great and mighty things. I thank you, Holy Spirit of God, to my God Almighty, come today, Lord Jesus Christ, and have, my God Almighty, this word to come forth. For so long, my God Almighty, where you see it fit, my God Almighty, to do it. Father, I want to give you the praise, the glory, and the honor. And I pray, Lord God Almighty, that everyone, my God Almighty, that happened to hear this message will able, oh God Almighty, to tune in and will able, my God Almighty, to get it in their spirit. Because, Lord God Almighty, there are many out there that are, my God Almighty, the activator for you, and they don't even know it, my God Almighty, that this word, my God Almighty, that you have bring forth, it's true. Because, Lord God Almighty, you're using them in a mighty and a powerful way. There's never a time that they have ever backed down to say they're not going to do whatever you ask of them to do. Lord Jesus Christ, I pray, Lord God Almighty, that you, oh God, will able to visit every one of your servant, my God Almighty, that allow yourself to be, my God Almighty, hallelujah, that activator for you, Lord God Almighty. I pray, Holy Spirit of God, that you, Lord Jesus Christ, will take over mind, body, heart, and soul. Move, oh God Almighty, in your might and in your power, and for everyone to get and to understand, my God Almighty, that it is not about limited God, but it is about my God Almighty to do, Lord Jesus Christ, whatever you ask to do, so that it can bring glory and honor to your name. Father, I want to give you the praise, the glory and the honor, for you, Lord Jesus Christ, is the everlasting Father. You are worthy, O God Almighty, and worthy to be praised. There is no other God like you. In the mighty precious name of Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit of God, great High Priest, great I Am, you are Lord, you are God, King of all kings and Lord of lords. Help, O God Almighty, hallelujah, whoever, Lord Jesus Christ, you have called to be that activator. Oh God, help them in their life so that they can rise up at this moment and to get it right, to be in that place where you want them to be, to bring glory and honor unto your name. Lord God Almighty, I want to thank you. Father, I want to bless you. I want to praise you. I want to praise and glorify your holy and your precious name, for you are the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh God Almighty, I thank you even for those, my God, that make up in their mind to do whatever, my God Almighty, you want them to do. Father God, bless, keep and sanctify. Oh God Almighty, never leave them nor forsake them, but be thou, Lord God Almighty, their guardian and their guide, as we give you praise and glory on this empowerment line and lift your name on high, for your name, oh God Almighty, is to be glorified. Be thou glorified, hallelujah. Be thou high and lifted up as we give you praise, glory and honor. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Be glorified, hallelujah. Be glorified, hallelujah. Be glorified, Lord Jesus Christ. Be glorified, hallelujah. Yeah.
Kunde.
And worship the Lord with their faces to the ground.
Hallelujah.
Receive a word from the Lord. Our answer should be amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. God has spoken. So let the church say amen. Yeah.
God. Hallelujah.
Thing to give thanks to the Lord. Amen.
Jesus, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glorify the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, God Almighty, for all that you have given unto me. Yes, God Almighty, I thank you. Glory, hallelujah. Thank you, God. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, blessed Jesus. I want to thank you, Jesus Christ. I want to thank you, God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah. We thank you, God Almighty. Thank you for your goodness and your mercy. My God Almighty. May the Lord Jesus Christ, my God Almighty, bless and keep everyone. May the face of the Lord God Almighty shine upon everyone. And as my God Almighty, this word, my God Almighty, has already gone forth. Which, my God Almighty, I believe there are more to come in the midst of preaching. I want to give God praise, glory, and honor. May the Lord bless and keep each and every one. For those that, my God Almighty, out there that is God's activator and don't know it. Able to listen to this message, if you see your life line up with what God is saying, know that you are one of them. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Oh God Almighty, I thank you, I bless you, I praise you, I glorify you. Just know, my people of God Almighty, hallelujah, that my God Almighty, this servant here, love you all very much. The Lord Jesus Christ love you more. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Be blessed, be blessed, be blessed without stress. In the mighty precious name of Jesus Christ, glory be to God, hallelujah. Jesus' name.